See, McCown, I'm like the Joker. I'm not all bad, you know what I'm saying? But Lil Jimmy, see? They got tired of me calling him Lil Jimmy. I took Lil Jimmy's drink.
Survivor Series 2011, Awesome Truth versus Cena and The Rock.
Miz told me that they was talking about it. I didn't believe him. Absolutely not. John Cena, I already had my capital punishment. To have John Cena and The Rock, myself and The Miz, Madison Square Garden, man, that's a dream made in heaven. That's better than homemade apple pie. You know what I'm saying? You can't eat that in one serving, right?
And now it's R-Truth planning Cena. And R-Truth and Rock outside the ring, Rock off the barricade.
I'm hearing the roar from everybody. I'm hearing the roar, but I could hear a pin drop because I'm outside of myself, watching myself in this moment here, like I'm living it. I would never be able to give you the full effect of how that felt. I can only tell you, you would never be able to experience a feeling like that.
Yeah, there you go, little Rocket.
He's that. We got him now. We got him now. But if you ain't never fell on your bottom in the ring before, you won't know what it feel like. And I fell on mine. I'm trying to get the Miz to make the tag. Damn it, he done tagged in the Rock. That's who we didn't want in, by the way.
That there!
Oh,
look at the Rock go!
Finished DDT
look at the Rock go! Oh my gosh! Laying the smack down! You got Rock! Bottom!
That's surreal. I'm in the ring with Rock. If Rock would have told me, hey, I'm going to give you a power drive off the top rope, and then we're going to go to the top in the middle of the light and do three black flips down, I'd have done it because I was in the ring with the Rock. It was that moment. Madison Square Garden, come on, man, I would have done it.
Oh, Rock still got it all right. And Truth showed up as well.
That's Truth right there, baby.
Yeah. Oh. Oh.
1 and 2 in my career. It's hard to top that. It's too many elements to top. That night before the match, me and Miz walked around the arena and looked at everybody that was in there that night. That has been and performed in Madison Square Garden. We said we're going to be out there tonight. Empty arena now, but we took time to walk and see who all the great ones that was in there. Because we're going to be on that wall, too. Matter of fact, we are on that wall.
Capital Punishment 2011 versus John Cena.
Well, Cole, you can say what you want to say about R-Truth, about all of his rants he's been going through as of late. I mean, totally being out of control. But R-Truth has put himself in a position tonight here to go for the WWE Championship. It's been 10 years. Everything he's done up until this point hadn't made it here. Tonight, he's in this position. Let's see if the man can cash in, cash that ticket, walk away with the WWE Championship.
A lot of people don't know. The build-up for Capital Punishment, that's when Little Jimmy was born. Little Jimmy was created. Little Jimmy was all the fans that my childhood hero John Cena had. I was calling all the fans Little Jimmys. Even everybody. Everybody was a Little Jimmy. I don't care how old you was a Little Jimmy.
Where's Little Jimmy at? Oh, man. Little Jimmy. Little Jimmy. See, y'all, look. R-Truth, I'm a good R-Truth now. That look good, don't it?
And Lil Jimmy became a person on the stage when I looked to my side and I was talking.
Hey, Lil Jimmy. Am I making you smile by singing What's Up? Shut up!
We took that into, I was angry because I never was given an opportunity. I was never given a fair shake at anything. So that just built up this thing between me and Cena, which was in itself like, again, I'm working with John Cena.
And Truth looking to put Cena away. WWE title on the line. Here we go for Truth. Can he do it here? And Cena powers out.
R-Truth gonna have to pick up the pace just a little bit. Look like he's gonna do it right now.
I said, I hate to do this to him, but at that time, I didn't care about none of that. I wanted the world title.
Drink that water, Truth!
Yeah. See, okay, I'm like the Joker. I'm not all bad, you know what I'm saying? But Lil Jimmy, see? They got tired of me calling him Lil Jimmy. I took Lil Jimmy's drink. And see, that's great. We all won. We all won. I wouldn't change nothing. I wouldn't change nothing because the build-up, we gave them what we built up to. Once I soaked the moment up, once I soaked up what was happening and pinched myself, I was proud. I was proud to be in that moment, living it, and giving that opportunity.
Royal Rumble 2016.
Entering at number 12 is R-Truth. R-Truth's eighth Royal Rumble match. I'm just happy you knew what day the Rumble was on. What? What is he doing? John, do you have any idea what R-Truth is doing here?
I know what he's doing, Michael. I don't know why.
I think I was confused by what pay-per-view it was. There was a big discrepancy in the back. And we couldn't figure out what pay-per-view it was. I'm hearing one thing on one side. They telling me this thing on that side. Oh, there's a ladder on it. Only pay-per-view that got a ladder involved was Money in the Bank, right? Just going by hearsay. You never go by hearsay. Unless they moved the briefcase before I got there. You feel me? These things happen.
Maybe he thought it was the Money in the Bank ladder match and he's eliminated by Kane.
Truth, he got confused.
What does he always say? My bad.
My bad. This was on me.
Even through the confusion and everything else, is it still rewarding that you get to make people put a smile on fans' face?
Yes. Yes. And that's one of the things I know I can do. And it's good. It makes people feel good. It makes people... It just does something... It soothed a beast. It's almost as good as gas. You know what I'm saying? Like, you feel good just smiling. A lady in the airport told me, she said, you know what? She said, you made my whole day just because you were smiling. She said, I don't even know who you are. Didn't know I'd rather just because I was smiling. For a stranger to say that to me, not knowing from wrestling, but to be able to do that, I love it. I live for it. Winning the United States title.
I'm walking out of here the United States champion because I'm the Miz! And I'm awesome!
I've always thought the Miz was like creatively underestimated. Not talked about as much as he should be for being a ring general.
And there's a reversal. Watch this. Oh, face first. Planting the Miz. R-Truth could be closing in on a victory. What a missile drop kick.
Just to be affiliated with anything with the Miz, I was like, damn, that's pretty cool. You know what I'm saying? And just to know his story from coming from the reality life to wrestling and living his dream, following those. That blueprint he made out for himself and sticking to it and being dedicated and just, I have number of admiration for him, always have. Again, he's one of the best and the most smartest person to have a connection with in the back.
What's he gonna do here? There,
scissor kick.
Went for the scissor kick and a block by the Miz. Who misses wildly. And there it is! Wow! R-Truth connecting! The lie detector has taken out the Miz! The new United States champion!
Winner of this match and new United States champion, R-Truth.
That meant the world to me. That meant you can check that off on the list. You know what I'm saying? As your accomplishment list, your bucket list, your I did it list. There's a lot of guys in this business won't ever get a chance to, like, I was one of them that did. I was one of them that could show other people that's like me that they can do it too. It's just so much was just in winning that title. I won not just for myself, I won for a lot of people that's been down the same road, same path as I've been down, regardless of the race or whatever. Just a lot of people just like me, I won for. When I win, they win. We win. It was kind of soaking in because everybody congratulated me. Everybody's clapping. I'm like, okay, yeah, y'all really, really doing this. Okay, for real? For real? For real? Okay. I'm going to take it home. I said, I'm going to take it home with me. He said, yeah, you're going to need it for the live events. You're going to need it. Okay, I'm going to put it in my bag. And then later on that night, I'm like, wow, I'm soaking it up. But now I'm like emotionally soaking it up to like, I'm proud of myself. You've never heard me say that before. And there's a lot of people that's probably not proud of themselves. They're happy for what they have done, what they've accomplished and that, but to be proud of yourself, I was proud of myself.
Hell in a Cell 2011, me and the Miz get arrested.
Superstars are trying to somehow get inside the cell, but they can't do it. It's locked. And Miz and R-Truth are laying waste to everything. My God, the carnage is overwhelming. This is a mugging.
Awesome Truth. Wow. I missed this. See, nobody expected this to come. After Cena, I moved on. I was still a good R-Truth, but I moved on with Miz. Everybody was shocked because they used to, you know what I'm saying, me smiling and kissing the babies and everybody. But they ain't used to seeing me come down there with no bats, locking the cage door, and just going ballistic on everything and everybody.
Oh, look at this. And R-Truth.
Look, me and Miz was confident. Everything he's saying, I'm buying. You know what I'm saying? If he's selling it, I'm buying. Because he's feeling what I'm feeling. And we feel like we should have more. And they're not gonna give us more, we're gonna take it. How? By any means necessary. Look, hey, we ain't done nothing. We ain't hurt nobody. You know what I'm saying? Like, we surrendered, as you can see, right? Oh, this was a fun time. Now, this was unexpected right here. I'm back in that moment. Watch Triple H. He's pissed at what happened.
Oh, that's what I'm talking about. Street justice. That's street justice right there.
Out of nowhere. See, call the law. Get the law on him. You see, that's who the police should have been going to get right there, Triple H. The way he beat us up.
I think Triple H is being arrested. And quite frankly, well,
he should not be arrested. What are you talking about?
That was fun. That was fun. I'm comfortable in the saddle now. Remember I told you, I just sat in it when I went back. I'm trotting and riding now. I can ride the horse now. I can take him around the bend. I'm good with the horse now. That's me being good with the horse. I knew there was more good to come.
Me and Carmella win the Mixed Match Challenge.
Oh, look at this. Truth and Carmella with the double hip toss.
Me and Carmella's partnership was, it was wonderful, man. It was great. It was funny, entertaining. Ring-wise, wrestling-wise, she's very smart wrestling-wise. She's underestimated. We just had a great chemistry. She liked to laugh. I like to laugh. We make it funnier than funny. And that was just our job, taking everything to the next level.
Yes! Break it down!
Oh, the Singh brothers!
Oh man, yeah. So this was fun. I mean, what we were doing was fun. And the dance break thing, the more we did that, signings, everybody wanted us to do the dance break.
Truth ending the dance break.
Turned into a dance battle.
Of not one, but both Singh brothers.
The crowd put me and Carmella together because it worked. Again, we have our own world, our own universe. And when things gel and mesh together, we let it. And the crowd, they picked that. And it worked.
Hey, you can't touch it! Shot! Yeah. Oh, and Alicia Fox. Oh, and for the scissor kick! Oh, Carmella with a super kick!
It's great. It fuels the engine again. Because now you're working on two cylinders instead of one. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody's putting in on it. You know what I'm saying? So, it makes it easy, it makes it fun. There's no egos, there's nobody tripping. It's smooth sailing. And when you get all that, it's not work. You're having fun.
Alicia Fox from behind. Carmella able to sidestep for the moment. Now Alicia Fox into the cover. Kicking out it. Oh, the code of silence! Oh,
submission move!
The code of silence! Alicia taps! Fox taps out! Carmella and R-Truth mixed
here
match
your
challenge
by
champions!
Submission. The team of R-Truth and Carmella!
We did something for Thanksgiving. It was 24-7. And they asked me to say Happy Thanksgiving. And I said, you said Happy Thanksgiving! Something she said, but she still says Happy Thanksgiving. I don't care what month it is. To say bye or hey, she was like, Happy Thanksgiving! And it goes back to when we was doing that.
WWE debut Raw, November 13, 2000.
You think you double team can't quit getting rowdy?
What is this? That's, what the hell is that's Kate Quick?
What?
Kate Quick just nailed William Regal with a microphone.
Ooh, the goosebumps. I'm getting the goosebumps now. I was ready for it to happen. I think I was already in the ring before I got in the ring. The day Road Dogg saw me, I was going to quit that following week. I was discouraged, out of money. I mean, man, I done lost faith in myself. I done lost faith in that I could do it.
Jay Quick and the Road Dogg hooked up on MTV last night.
He asked me why, and I was like, I don't think I belong. He's like, you do belong. He's like, I just saw you and went through this whole thing. He's like, I want to bring you back my tag partner. Road Dogg breathed that life back into me when he said that. It meant the world to me.
It ain't time for you to be out here strapping. It's time to raise the roof, get rowdy, and start rapping.
It was electrifying out there, man. Look at the crowd. I'm soaking all the things I know what we're about to do.
You better call somebody.
D-O-double-G.
And can't quit, get rowdy.
That pop gave me that feeling of belong. I'm one of them. This is home to me. This universe, this wrestling, we have our own world. That right there to me gave me the sense of belonging. Yes. Oh, you didn't know? You better call somebody.
Through the dusk of the mist and fall. No damn doubt about it. Can't cricket. Road Dogg, get rowdy.
To be able to incorporate the rap side of me with the WWE wrestling side of me, man, like a hand in glove. The music sets the tone. The music pretty much, it lights the fuse for the pop, for the crowd, right? You know what I'm saying? Like, any and everything that usually what we do, sports, is always some music in it. Yeah, the ball guy. Music is a part of everything. It gives you that feel. It just slaps you in the face, really, you know what I'm saying? So being able to like give you that adrenaline rush, like that fuse, and then blow it up, can't ask for no more. Man, see, I'm living my dream right here. I have a whole different audience now. It ain't the rap game, it's the wrestling universe. And look, it's packed, man. It's electrifying. Look at the audience. Look at it. I was accepted today. Right then and there, wrestling became, I became it. That was it. Sold, not bought, it's me, boss.
Tossing around, going to real G's with the real answer. We're getting rowdy. What?
Return to WWE SmackDown, August 29, 2008.
This bout is set for one fall. Making his SmackDown debut from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 235 pounds, R-Truth.
What's up? What's up? People over there, what's up?
Well, a much anticipated debut of R-Truth, JR. Exciting young athlete, I think so here.
I have been amazed and enthralled with the vignettes that we have seen on this young man documenting his life.
Me coming back in 2008 was just a visualization of how mad I was. You know what I'm saying? Mentally, crazy mad. Like, you know what I'm saying? I wanted to know what they were dealing with, who they were dealing with. It wasn't the same K-Quick that debuted with Road Dogg. It's a grown man you're dealing with now. A grown man with feelings, emotions, disappointments, jealousy, anger, just hostile. But each one of those feelings, I was still able to connect with the audience. I was still able to connect with the fans because every last one of those fans felt those feelings before.
Quickness and speed, young man's put together too.
Oh, wow! The feeling was still belonging, but I don't think I had truly blossom into that butterfly yet. Mentally, physically, I'm there. Of course, we know the physical part is there, but I wasn't who I am now. Like, I know them people, I can connect with them, like, boom. There, I was just happy to be back.
Unorthodox offense.
Here we go.
And the scissors kick. With authority, right in the back of the head. This could be, and it is true.
This definitely, it blew the life into me for the second time, and it blew into me what I needed. It's the first time riding a horse, you know what I'm saying? I don't get thrown off of it, like, but I'm used to that horse. I'm used to him riding it, but I wasn't able to start trotting yet. The longer, when I started trotting, once I got into the little gym and stuff, then me and the horse running now. So yeah, this moment is just me getting back on the horse, in the saddle.
24/7 title race.
You gotta come out here and just relax a little bit.
I wanna see your golf game.
I'm gonna show you my golf game.
Okay,
my golf game is nothing. Hold on! Ref!
Down! 1, 2, 3!
Give me the title!
What are you doing?
Give me the title!
Are you kidding me? We're out here golfing, trying to relax!
It's 24/7!
I don't know what you think you're doing!
Whoa! Down! 1, 2, 3!
Come on, Trout!
Carmella actually drug me on this golf cart right here. Ah, she drug me. I have some fresh white shoes. I just bought those white shoes too. Grass stains, all. And she didn't stop.
Now they can't give me a foreign
grip. On the tarmac. I was on the phone, man. I was on the phone really with my wife, man, on an international call. And he did that.
1, 2, 3!
At this point right now, I've done so much with that 24/7 title, it became my baby. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about like Gaga Goo Goo. It became my baby.
Thanks for the hospitality, President. Mr. Burns. RoboCop, you take it easy. Arriba Dolce, Taranara. See you guys later. One, two, three.
The mayor of Knox County, come on, man. Who would ever thought a title could bring two people together? Man, that title was almost like a dating title, you know what I'm saying? Like, you can. It brought lives together, worlds together.
And new 24/7 champion, I still got it.
To me, I think it just brings every walks of life together. It can bring any line of celebrity work into our field of entertainment. It's hard to pick a moment in time where it doesn't feel good because they all felt good, you know? They all had their own moments because it was my baby. The Gag Gag Goo Goo baby I'm talking about, yes.
It doesn't matter, 24/7. R-Truth's the new champion.
I think it's very important to look back. That's what keeps you moving forward. It opens the memory book back up. It opens up that emotion I was feeling at that time. It opens up what I was thinking at the time, what I was going through at that time. And it gives me gratitude because of where I'm at now.